now.
All right, we are flipping it and kicking it with Todd this morning. Hey, Todd.
Good morning, guys. Hello from the Morton Salt Mine out in Fairport Harbor. Did you even know that they were mining salt every day, 24/7, underneath Lake Erie? Well, they do right here at the Morton Salt Mine. In fact, they're loading up some of the trucks right now. So this salt right here, it's all road salt. It's not food grade salt that they have here in Fairport Harbor. So all this road salt is going to be sent out to municipalities so that they can put salt on the roads, on the highways. They also bag it up here to put in your driveways. So I had the chance to go 2,000 feet under Lake Erie. It was a fun, really cool type thing. Here's a look at what we did. All right, kicking it with Todd. We're down here 2,000 feet under the ground. We're getting ready to travel 2,000 feet out under Lake Erie to do this here with Jen. Jen, your spokesperson here from Morton Salt. Thank you for being here with us.
My pleasure.
It was an okay ride down.
Yeah, I think it's great. It's fascinating, right? You've never done this before?
Not at all. And this is all salt we're looking at. So everything on the wall
is
salt.
It sure is. Yeah, absolutely. And so as you said, we're about 0.4 mile underground. We're going to head 3 miles under Lake Erie and show you the salt deposit we mine from.
Now, as we look around, we see a lot of the vehicles that are down here. And obviously, that's got to come down in only certain space to get down here. You guys have to take a lot of that apart and put it back together.
We sure do. So we've got two different shafts that we can bring people and equipment down, and we're limited by a basically 5-foot by 5-foot piece. So you'll see some pretty big pieces of equipment as we take this tour, and just recognize we've had to disassemble a lot of this and put it back together just like a big tinker truck.
I love, you guys have what, about 170 employees?
120 or so.
120, yeah.
Yeah.
And a lot of them have been here for a long time.
Absolutely. Many are generational workers. I mean, we're really proud that some of these folks have been here second, third generation. So in a lot of pride, you'll see just a Go Tribe painted on the side of the salt deposit. A lot of pride here from this Northeast community.
As we go out, so, I mean, it's dark. I mean, you can see it's getting darker here. See big piles of salt. And obviously, getting through this is not the easiest thing to do.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So we've got folks, like we said, 120 people that work above and underground. Okay. And for the guys and gals that work underground, they come down and they work their whole shift under here. And they're used to that. This is what they do on a day-to-day basis.
Now, you guys have Wi-Fi down here.
We're working on improving our Wi-Fi communications. Right. But yeah, when you work miles apart in a very isolated environment, communication is key. You know, safety is really the most important thing that we do every day. So we need to find ways to make sure we can communicate.
When the miners are down here, I mean, it's got to be that community, because you're down here for so long with people and you're isolated from the topside world. You know, it's got to be a real sense of community with all those workers.
It absolutely is. Plus, you know, the other thing is you're really in this together as a team, right? You're not interfacing with anybody else but your coworkers. You're not even seeing daylight, quite frankly, until you come back up. So
what are we looking at here?
So here we're going to go through these doors just to get into a different part of the mine. This part is really just a travel aisle that's been excavated decades ago. So what we're going to take you into is the heart of the mine, where you're going to see some recent blasting that we've done in order to bring de-icing salt up to the surface to keep our community safe.
That's awesome. All right, well, we'll have more coming up. Kicking it with Todd right here, Morton Salt Mine underground, 2,000 feet under Lake Erie. Ground in Fairport Harbor. Now, obviously, we couldn't get a signal from all the way down underneath the lake to up here, so we had to record that, and we did that recently. But the nice thing about that, Wayne and Christy, it's like, what, 32, I have mist blowing on me. Down there, underneath the mine, it's like a constant 75, 80 degrees.
Isn't that crazy?
It's so quiet. It's like a very peaceful environment down there. And they have, all the air is blown around, so it's refreshed. It's all circulated and fresh air down there. You could live down there.
It's like a different world, isn't it?
And maybe in the wintertime, I might want to.
I know, that's right.
We need a couple, we need a Chipotle down there.
We do, you know, and then you could just stay down there for the whole winter. Just hibernate.
It's Todd's favorite.
Yeah.
Coming up, we're going to go all the way 3.5 miles out into Lake Erie.
Okay.
Under 2,000 feet down. We're going to show you the difference between the entrance to the mine that was built in 1958 and what they're doing right now, actually, as we speak.
Okay.
Incredible.
Yeah, very fascinating. Thank you, Todd.